rising in Orlando. It's a mixed bag for the economy. The Labor Department says the economy added just under 1.4 million new jobs in August, down from 1.8 million in July. And says CBS's Jill Schlesinger,
the unemployment rate dropped to 8.4%, down from 10.2%. The unemployment rate would be about 0.7 percentage points higher if people properly categorized why they were out of work.
The Bell S&P futures were up 3 points. President Trump has promised a vaccine by the end of the year. Scientists say it's possible, but not a given worldwide. World Health Organization's Margaret Hammer says it'll be a different story.
In terms of realistic timelines, we're really not expecting to see widespread vaccination until the middle of next year.
Mr. Trump is under fire for what he allegedly said in canceling out of a visit to a military cemetery in Paris 2 years ago. CBS Stephen Portnoy.
A 2018 Veterans Day visit to an American cemetery outside Paris has been scrapped due to what the White House called scheduling and logistical difficulties.
Jeffrey Goldberg writes in The Atlantic that Mr. Trump didn't want his hair to get messed up in the rain. Goldberg says four people told him. The president told his senior staff the cemetery was filled with losers. Mr. Trump furiously refuted the allegations and others in the story last night.
Probably it's a couple of people that have been failures in the administration that I got rid of, and I couldn't get rid of them fast enough. But more was just made up.
The man accused of killing a right-wing protester last weekend in Portland, Oregon, himself has been killed in a gunfight with federal agents in Washington State.
Good point. Cincinnati, you've got a couple of things that are working here. Number one, there are still over 7 million people who are working part-time because they can't find full-time jobs. There are another 7 million people who are looking for work, but they can't find anything at all out there. So you've got a lot of people who are discouraged. You also have a lot of people who are concerned about the schools opening up, colleges opening up, reports that we're getting that COVID-19 is the cases are increasing. The question is unanswered, and there is no answer for it right now. What impact is that going to have? Bottom line, economists are happy today. Better than expected report, but their fingers are crossed because they don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. Patty.
Futures up almost 160 now. We'll check in with Detroit 925, just ahead of the opening bell. New this hour, there have been three straight nights of drive-by shootings on one Ypsilanti Township street. WWJ's Brooke Allen live local with that story, Brooke.
Well, Tom, investigators say those shootings should stop now that two suspects are in custody. The Washington County Sheriff's Department says a 19-year-old and a 20-year-old were arrested overnight after one home on Foley Street, which is near I-94 and Harris Road, were shot on the third straight night. Investigators say one person was